This is how to create this magnifying effect in Premiere Pro. First, we need to create an adjustment layer. So go to the project panel, click on new item, and then adjustment layer, and then click OK. Now drag the adjustment layer above the clip in the timeline. Now to add the effect, simply head over to effects panel and search magnify, and apply it to the adjustment layer that we have just created. Now in the previous screen, we can already see the circle with the magnification applied to it. Now to make it easier to see it, you can simply adjust the scale value under magnify in effects controls. You can now change the center values so that the circle is in your desired location that you want to zoom in on. And you can also change the magnification value in order to choose the amount of zoom that will be applied. You can also adjust the shape of the magnification by going on the drop-down menu under shape and then selecting square. If you now play back the video, you can see the magnification effect, but it looks really boring and unprofessional. So let's animate it. In effects controls, simply press on the stopwatch next to scale in order to create a keyframe, and then move it forward a bit. On the start of the clip, we don't want the effect to be visible, so set the scale value down to 0, or in this case 1, because 0 doesn't work. Now the next step might be easier if you zoom in a bit into the keyframes. Now select both keyframes and then right click ease in, then right click again and select ease out. We are now going to change the speed of the animation by clicking on the arrow next to scale. This will open up a graph that we can use to manipulate the speed of the animation. Now go to the bottom graph and drag the second keyframe's point all the way to the left. When dragging the graphs all the way to the left, make sure that you don't move it up or down, as this will mess up the animation. And if you mess this up, then you can simply press Ctrl and C to undo. And if these lines aren't visible to you, then simply click on one of the keyframes. If you now play back the clip, we can see that we got a nice little animation. Now for the end animation, simply move the player a bit forward, then click on circle next to scale to create a keyframe for the current value. Now move forward again, and then set the value down to 0. Now click on one of the keyframes in order to make changes. Now this time, drag the first point all the way to the right. And if you now play back the video, we can see that we got a nice in and out animation. Now subscribe so you don't miss any new videos, and I will see you in the next one.